Welcome to Direct Talk. Our guest today is Morinari Watanabe, a member of the International Olympic Committee. He is also the president of the International Gymnastics Federation, which is the governing body of gymnastics, rhythmic gymnastics, trampoline, and other related disciplines. Watanabe is spearheading innovation in sports that puts athletes and spectators above all else. In recent years, he has actively introduced measures that address issues of sexual harassment allegations that have come to light in the world of gymnastics. Furthermore, he has set out to develop AI-assisted scoring in gymnastics, where the increasing complexity of routines has made the sport difficult to follow with just the human eye. Some in the world of sports call Watanabe the flag bearer of innovation. We asked him about his vision and his approach.
In October 2018, Morinari Watanabe was elected as a new member of the International Olympic Committee. The appointment of an unremarkable gymnast was notable for a committee largely comprised of aristocrats, royalty, and former Olympic athletes. One of the reasons he was elected to the IOC was that the IOC president, Thomas Bach, recognized the changes Watanabe had brought in the world of gymnastics. One of those changes involved the work Watanabe had done to address sexual harassment in the world of gymnastics after being named the president of the International Gymnastics Federation in 2017.
It came to light that the doctor of the USA Gymnastics national team had molested many girls during doctor's visits. The gymnasts had kept the abuse to themselves for a long time, because they were afraid if they spoke up, it would affect their chances of being appointed to the national team. Each nation, each sport, has its own national association, but sometimes that can have a negative effect. I take a hands-on approach, so I went to the U.S. to meet the victims and their guardians. I made them a promise that I would dedicate my life to eradicating sexual harassment from our sport. So I immediately set up a Gymnastics Ethics Foundation. Gymnasts can now make an emergency call from anywhere in the world 24 hours a day, and an independent organization will hear what they have to say. Athletes in other sports will see that, and they'll ask for a similar hotline to be set up for them to report sexual harassment. I think this will naturally spread to other sports. These national associations would not exist without the athletes themselves. What we're doing is a world's first. So I am committed to making it a success.
Watanabe is dedicated to bringing changes to gymnastics that put athletes first. Watanabe himself first took up gymnastics around the late age of 16.
One day, me and four of my buddies were playing around at our school's gymnastics gymnasium. The manager shows up and asks us what we thought we were doing. He'd caught us making mischief, so I spouted, "We were thinking of joining the gymnastics team." And the manager replies, "We have a competition in a week, and you're up." What? I couldn't even do a handstand. But that's where it all started. Looking back, it was all a series of coincidences, but I can't help but think that it was inevitable. I've been lifted up into my position as president of the International Gymnastics Federation. I've been lifted up onto the International Olympic Committee. I've met so many people who have helped me in my career. That's why I'm where I am today.
Watanabe continued doing gymnastics at university. In 1981, during his junior year, he took advantage of a school program to study abroad in Bulgaria.
I wanted to learn why members of the communist bloc were so good at sports. I worked as a gymnastics coach for their national team. The head coach of the rhythmic gymnastics team at the time invited me to come and see what they were doing. And I was blown away. The gymnasts are asked what piece of music they want to use for their routine. They get a say. So the gymnast explains what song they want to use and what sort of routine they want to do. Then they're tasked with studying the historical background of the music. the composer, and that forms the basis for their routine. I got goosebumps. They were taught that unless they enriched themselves on the inside, they would be unable to perform at a high level. The Japanese economy was doing well at the time. It was all about chasing material things, money, things like that. But when I went to Bulgaria, I saw that people were in poverty. There were days when they couldn't even buy bread. But despite their situation, people were still going to see painting exhibitions and theatrical performances. They were monetarily poor, but spiritually wealthy. I believe that the era of material wealth will eventually come to an end. And what will people look for then? Spiritual fulfillment. I realize that rhythmic gymnastics is a sport that will really find its stride in the 21st century, so I needed to introduce it into Japan.
Upon returning to Japan, Watanabe went around to various corporations with a proposal for opening a rhythmic gymnastics club as a business. A major hypermarket chain embraced the plan. Watanabe worked on the sales floor, including the women's wear department, while concurrently running his rhythmic gymnastics club.
If I could turn the club into a business, I'd be producing a profit, and I could use that profit to make sports part of the corporate identity. So, in the end, I could raise the company's image without losing them any money.
That's what Watanabe told the company as he launched his rhythmic gymnastics club. But only three kids enrolled, putting him in a difficult position.
This carpet costs 5 million yen. How was I going to produce a profit after spending 5 million yen? My bosses were very angry with me. It all comes down to seeing things from the consumer's perspective. If you want to sell something, consumers have to want to buy it. You have to sell products that customers will want to buy. Or you have to sell them on your product. So I designed different flyers, and there are many apartments in this area. So in the morning and evening, I went around putting flyers in mailboxes, free one-day lesson, things like that. From a business perspective, these things are not costs, they're investments. So you have to develop a habit of investing and figuring out how to turn that into profit.
Watanabe's do-or-die PR strategy sparked word of mouth for his rhythmic gymnastics club. He currently runs over 30 across the country. However, recognizing that being the sole company running such clubs had its limits, he encouraged his gymnasts to branch out on their own and endeavor to nurture private clubs.
I told other coaches that it's important to have gymnasts, active and retired alike, branch off and set up their own clubs nearby. Don't worry about competition, just create lots of clubs. I put the most energy into cultivating coaches. I held management seminars to instill in them business and management sense. I developed a framework for creating your own gymnastics club. And we use that to reach a wider audience. Right now, there are over 1,000 private rhythmic gymnastics clubs. Our sport has spread.
Aided by Watanabe's efforts, Japan's rhythmic gymnastics team has won medals in both group and individual categories at the World Championships. In recognition of his work to spread rhythmic gymnastics in Japan, Watanabe was appointed executive committee member of the Japan Gymnastics Association in 2000, tasked with reforming gymnastics as a whole. First, he turned his attention to reforming competitive gymnastics, where he had gotten his start.
I went to a competition, and the only people there were the people involved. Not a great start. The value of marketing is figuring out how to attract people who are uninterested. Audiences are only interested in sports that have entertainment value. We brought in a DJ. And it's difficult to see what's going on down on the floor, so we put them up on a stage. We experimented with how to use music and how to use large screens to make scores more clear. We wanted to make a competition a show, and that motivates athletes to do their best. And once they start to become stars, our fan base will grow. A larger fan base, of course, is a business opportunity. So that will get us capital, and in turn, we channel that money into making our competitions more of an entertainment. That establishes a cycle, and I believe helping our sport become bigger will help it grow.
Our gymnastics is now and will be the king of the sports.
These were Watanabe's words when he was appointed president of the International Gymnastics Federation in 2017. The appointment was in recognition of his efforts to make gymnastics a major global competitive sport, visiting over 100 countries and regions worldwide. What's more, he partnered with a major home appliances maker to develop an AI-assisted scoring system. His goal was to make scoring easier to understand for both gymnasts and the audience.
People watch gymnastics and go, wow, but no one can explain what or why it's so amazing. It's too complex. Did the gymnast twist three times or four? The average spectator can't tell. We have to be better about explaining what's going on. Moreover, the scoring criteria for domestic and international competitions are different. Using the system we're developing would make scoring much clearer. It would make calls much clearer.
The scoring system uses the latest 3D sensors, which emit 2 million rays per second. Multiple sensors are placed throughout an area, enabling the system to capture a gymnast's movements and posture in three dimensions. An AI converts the data points into a CGI model. It calculates the values relevant to scoring, helping judges give scores to gymnasts. Take the vault, for example. The difficulty of skills differs by the gymnast's posture while in flight. By quantifying the bend at the hips, it becomes easier to assign a score. The system allows judges to see a performance from every angle and judge separate elements at a glance, such as if a gymnast's legs are apart when they should be together. For spectators, the names and difficulty of different skills and the scores they're given can be displayed in real time, deciphering the performance they're watching. The system can also be used to help athletes train and learn new skills. Watanabe hopes to use the system in the 2020 Tokyo Olympics.
Judges have had the authority to give scores. This will change that. So it is no small matter. However, there have been times where judging errors have left an athlete in tears, and I think it's unacceptable for an athlete to be brought to tears by a bad call. This will make things fair. Figure skating, diving, judo, which has had issues with scoring. This system can be transplanted to all places, put to use in all sports. In the beginning, the system will provide support for the judges. The scoring will be system assisted. And ultimately, I think we will enter an era where computers determine the scores. Behind the scenes. I want to provide support for athletes from behind the scenes. I'm now a member of the International Olympic Committee. But as a gymnast, I wasn't particularly successful. And I don't like to be in the spotlight. All I want is to support our athletes. By doing what we do behind the scenes, if we can draw attention towards our athletes and help them shine, nothing would make me happier. I'll gladly do the thankless tasks, bow my head to make a request or make an apology. That's what my life is about.